Good afternoon, everybody. As usual, Mr. Punmiya, a program on wills has a lot of interest. A program by you has a lot of interest. As you know, every time you come here, it's a packed audience, and we really thank you for accepting our invitation for the fourth time. This is Mr. Punmiya's second talk on wills, and what makes it special is that all of you who want to make a will usually have a property to donate, and Mr. Punmiya is an expert on property. We have Mr. Shanbagh over here, who is our expert when it comes to handling legal queries, and he will tell you that the maximum number of queries to our legal helpline are all about housing societies and property. So it gives me great pleasure to have someone who will not only talk on wills, he really knows the subject backwards and has an amazing array of anecdotes on what happens with every individual will, because we may write what we want to in our will, but how it plays out is different in every single case, and there's nobody better than someone who has handled it, who understands accounts and who understands property matters to speak to us. So thank you very much, Mr. Punmiya. To give you a little bit of formal background, Mr. Punmiya is a chartered accountant for the past 39 years. He's the partner of Vimal Punmiya and Company. He's written a number of books on subjects like transfer of flats, stamp duty, registration, capital gains, NRI provisions, etc. He's a prominent speaker. He's spoken at 1,000 seminars in India as well as abroad on a vast range of subjects from the union budget. In fact, he's done a budget program for us. Income tax and audit provisions, stamp duty and registration, cooperative housing society issues, reserve bank provisions, among other subjects. He's a very socially concerned person. He's held several top ranking posts in cultural organizations. He served as co-chairman of the Company Law and Taxation Committee of the All India Manufacturing Organization. He's attached to nearly 100 companies, trusts, firms, as either an advisor, director, auditor, or a trustee. He's a recipient of a number of prestigious awards from prominent trade organizations and social organizations, including the Bharat Merchants Chamber, the Maharashtra Chamber of Housing Industry, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and others. He's a member of the Standing Committee of TDS, appointed by the Income Tax Department. He's also the chairman of the All India Business Council, honorary treasurer of the Remaking of Mumbai Federation, and he's an honorary patron of the Estate Agents Association of India. He's also associated with the Lions Club and has been a past president of the Chapati Club. And he is a regular contributor of articles to the Times of India, Hindustan Times, and other professional journals. May I request you to give him a big round of applause, and may I invite him to come next.
From next 1 hour and 15 minutes, we are going to discuss about the various provisions of will and nomination. Then, of course, followed by question answer for another 45 minutes or so. Now, friends, in a lot of other seminars, now you have learned how to make wealth, then how to manage wealth. Now, today we are going to discuss how to distribute wealth. Because when, for example, I have certain properties, movable property, immovable properties, after my death, when I am not there, how I want to distribute my assets, and what care I must take that whatever my intentions are there, that is followed. Because that time I will be not there to see which item goes to whom. So I have to make a will. And nomination, two things are very important. By making a nomination, what we do, we appoint a trustee. For example, I file a nomination in the society in favor of my wife. I want to give flat to my wife. I file a nomination form, signed by me, give detail of the flat, two witnesses sign, and society take two copy of first and give me signature on one. Within 7 days, they give me second copy also, and it is registered. Now, for example, my intention is to give that flat to my wife. And assuming my wife sells that flat after my death, she may sell for 3 crore rupees. And if I not made a will, then if I have one son and one daughter, she will able to keep only 1 crore. 1 crore she has to give to my son, 1 crore to my daughter. But if I make a will along with that, and I say the flat will go to my wife, then whole 3 crore will remain with her only. So that is the main difference. By nomination, we appoint a trustee. Under the will, we give the right of inheritance if so-and-so person will get the money. In our country, will is again further important, because in our country, we have 36,000 acts, and each and every act we know is complicated. Against each act, there is a rule how to follow the act. When rules are not clear, notification comes. When notification is not clear, circulars come, and they make complete mess of everything. And 2 years back, one NGO of the world, they made some survey and they found out that as far as India is concerned, they made survey of 187 countries. And out of that, to do obtain the government permission for anything, our number was 182. It means only 4-5 countries are worse than us. We are in that stage. Then you forget about taking money from the government. I want to pay to the government, income tax or service tax or sales tax or whatever tax. Then our number comes to 122. When you want to make the payment to the country, then also things are not that simple when you want to pay. To do business in our country, our number is 184. And corruption is concerned, our number is 97. So, looking to overall situation, one must make things very properly, very systematically. So later on, when for example, life is not educated, my children may not be capable, then I must make sure that they get whatever little money I have in their hand without any much hassle, without any much other procedure. But what is attracting in our country? Then why foreigners are coming, why foreign exchange comes? Because there is a population. So whatever they manufacture, it is consumed in our country. And that is the main attraction, population, 1/6 of the world population in our country. So that is the main attraction. But will become very important after death. For example, I make a will today, I give, distribute the wealth. Tomorrow, my wealth may go up, my wealth may go down, I change my mind, there may be some diverse. Today I am not married, tomorrow I may get married. So one can change the will also. So will is affecting only after the death. It is not that today I made the will, so tomorrow I am going to die and day after tomorrow my children will get the money. I will live for 100 years. After that, it will be effective. Then, if I have not made a will, then of course, various law will be applicable, which contain Indian Succession Act, Hindu Personal Law, Muslim Law, Indian Registration Act. As far as Indian Succession Act is applicable, that will apply to Hindu, Buddhist, Sikh, Jain, Parsi have their separate law, Christian have their separate law, Muslim have their separate law. So their wealth will go as per that law. And we shall discuss later. Now, what is the essential of the will? Essential thing, first, it is effective only after death. One, I can change the will every day in my lifetime. One of my client, he has got 4 children. He was having shop in Jabri Bazar. He sold the flat, sold one bigger flat in Bandaril area. He has 4 sons. So he bought separate 4 shop for all the 4 children, separate 4 shop for the all the flat for the all the children. Then he kept 75 lakh rupees with him, which he put in the bank and earning interest. Now he divided 3 months, he remained with children number 1, next 3 months children number son number 2, son 3, son 4, like that. When he goes to son number 1, he only wants to make him a will. About 75 lakh. He said, daddy, what will happen after your death? 75 lakh. So he makes will in favor of son A. After 3 months, when he goes to son 2, same issue comes back. So again he makes a will. When he goes to third son, he makes third will. Fourth son, fourth will. And this way he made 32 will in last nearly 10 years. So will is not a document. You can make change whenever you want. But if first will is registered, for if I make a will today, the registration is not compulsory, but assuming I register, I want government of Maharashtra to become witness of my will, and I register the will, then when I make the changes, that also has to be registered. Otherwise, the second will have no value. If one first is not registered, then second also need not be registered. But once it is registered, the second has to be registered. Then it is of course revocable. Now, who are the person who is competent to make a will? Whether anyone can make. First, I can make will of my own property. I'm partner in a partnership firm. I can make a will of my share, 25% or 10%. I cannot distribute the wealth of the partnership firm. I can, for example, I manage the Bank of Baroda. I am in control of more than 500 crore, already 5,000 crore. But I cannot make will of property belong to Bank of Baroda. I cannot say my elder son will get Chandigarh railway station, younger son will get the PT station, and daughter will get the airport. I can make will of my property, not somebody else's property. So that is very important. A person of sound mind can make a will. A minor cannot make a will. But if minor attain the age of 18 years, then he can make a will. But for example, if parents passed away, he is represented by guardian, then minor can make will only after attaining 21 years. So if parents is passed away, then after 18 years also he cannot make a will. He can make only after 21 years. If parents are there, then after 18 years. A married woman can make a will of her property. A dumb person, blind person can also make a will. An ordinary insane person can make a will only when he is of a normal temperature. For example, he is not in proper senses, he is drunk, then the will is not valid. But if he is proper sense, for example, one person, he may only from 1 to 2 in normal, otherwise he cannot understand what he is doing. Then that period he make a will and it is proved, then that will be valid. Then person, lunatic, insane person, suffering from illness, minor below the age of 18 years, those corporate entity, partnership firm, charitable trust, those cannot make the will. Only individual person can. I cannot make will of my HUF property. I can make will of my individual property. But if I partition, I can write this way, if I am a member of so-and-so HUF, in future, whenever partition takes place, and whatever sale will come to me, that I can make a will. So future, so it will be not divided today. When partition takes place, at that point of time, whatever my share will go to my wife or children or whatever I want. Otherwise, I cannot make actually the will of the HUF property. The HUF may you are holding as a trustee. For example, the Vimal Punmiya HUF, the Vimal Punmiya individual. Individual, I have wealth of say 2 crore rupees. I can make a will. My HUF also have another 2 crore. I cannot make will of that money. But if a partition takes place, I get my share, maybe 1 crore, maybe 50 lakh, maybe 1.5 crore with mutual consent of all family member, that portion I can make will afterwards. Then what is the need of a will? Need means then only how I want my asset to be distributed after my death, that is the main object of the will. And when person dies without making the will, I told you, Hindu law will apply. Will is absolutely a personal document. For example, I make a will, I did not disclose to my wife, I did not disclose to my son, I did not disclose to my daughter. But if I appoint my wife as an executor, I must take her consent, whether she is agreeable to do all exercise after my death. Because she has to collect the money, she has to distribute the money. So you have to take consent of the executor. Need not be writing, oral consent is also okay. And otherwise, I need not inform my children, I have given you this flat, I have not given you that flat. If I want to disclose, then also no problem. If I don't want to disclose, then not legally not required also. For example, my children are minor. I can say, I am giving this property to my son. But in case of my death and my children remain minor at that point of time, I appoint Mr. So-and-so, maybe my relative, maybe my friend, maybe institutions, Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, anyone as a trustee. But if I appoint Bank of Baroda or Bank of India as a trustee, then I must take their consent in advance. If I appoint any other person, I must take their consent in advance. So executor or trustee, I have to obtain their consent in advance. For example, if I don't make a will, let us assume I have 2 sons, 1 wife. One son is abroad, he is doing very well, has got a lot of money. So I want to protect the son who is with me, who is taking care of me. If I not made a will, my wealth will be divided in 3 parts. Wife will get 1/3, son will get 1/3, American son will get 1/3. I'll just give an example. One person was there, staying on Warden Road. He was 80 years old, staying with the son who was in India. 2 sons were abroad, both were outside India for 35 years. In 35 years, they were not visited. After his death, son has taken care of the mother. Mother passed away first. Then father was there. Father died at the age of 80. Father has not made any will. After death of the father, son informed that the third son who was staying with the parents informed that other 2 brothers. They also came to India. Before their condolence meeting, within 3 days, both children of America who came to India, they said, let us sell this flat of 3,000 square foot, divide the property, you keep 1/3, give us 2/3. And believe me, within 12 days, they sold the flat, recovered the money, shifted outside India. But when they have not taken care of father in last 40 years, they have not even met the father in last 40 years, they have not called a single time to the father in last 40 years from America. But at the time of death, they came to collect the money. Had father made a will and protected this son properly, okay, 2/3 this man will get, 1/3 will go to these 2 children, or he will get 100%, or whatever the percentage is, then he would have been in better position. Otherwise, he sold the flat and the Warden Road, shifted somewhere in Warsaw area. So that is the importance of a will, who will get after the death of the person. In case wife is staying separately, son is staying with the father, after death the father has not made will in name of a son, then naturally the wife who is staying separately for last number of years will come and claim. Now how to prepare a will? Now, preparing a will, it must be in writing. You can't say orally I divide like this. It has to be in a writing. But a person, Muslim family can be oral also. Person in army, air force, navy, at a time of war, they can make a oral will. Within 10 days, they can make oral will in presence of the witnesses, two witness, two army officer or two army men. And they have to make a declaration within 10 days. Yes, before his death, we made will like this orally. And we allocate the asset like this. Otherwise, will has to be in a writing. Oral will not serve any purpose. There is no particular format. It is a very simple document. If assets are not many, you simply write name of the person. I am Vimal Punmiya. My age is so. I reside in a so-and-so place. I have a mental, I have a sound mind. I have the following relative. Because you must remember all your relative. Otherwise, person whose relative name you have not written, they can claim that my father has forgotten that time. So wife, son, daughter, daughter-in-law, grandchildren. Their name, age and relationship. Then say, I appoint Mr. So-and-so as my executor who will take care of me after my death. Now many times it happens, executor died before the person testator dies. Because I make a will, I appoint Mr. A as executor, he passed away first before my death. Then, I can change the, so I can say, provide there, if A expires, then B will be executor. Or otherwise, all beneficiary will be executed in the will. Even when the executor dies, still will be valid, will not become invalid. Other legal heir will remain then. Then I say, I have following immovable properties. I have following immovable properties. And then I can allocate, this property will go to so-and-so, this property will go to so-and-so. And somebody want to make a very simple way, we can say, everything will go to my wife only, till she is there. If she predeceases me, if she dies before my death, then it will go like this. So normally, whenever simple will be made, everything husband give to the wife, wife give to the husband. And in case she is not there, or he is not there, this will go to children like this way. So that is the simplest way. But when we want to make more and more complications, I will be wondering how complicated one person came. He is from Jaldibazar. He has got four sons. He came to Bombay where he was earning 5 rupees per month as a salary. Today he has maybe nearly 1000 crore plus. Now he has four sons. All four sons have shops. But all comes at morning at 6 o'clock at home. Whole day they are home. Whole night they are out. So father is not happy with any of the sons. But all four daughter-in-law are there. So he came to me, he said, I want to make a will in such a way. He is also sure, in, after he is there, all four children will divide their assets and they will dispose of, spend the money, and again, after maybe after 5 years or 10 years, all will be in the footpath. That feeling he has got. So he wants to distribute assets in a such a way that son cannot sell anything. And all income of the fund will go to four daughter-in-law. Because he is very confident about no daughter-in-law, they say all are four good, they will take care of my grandchildren. So we made a trust. Trust under the will. Normal trust if I make, then I am liable to pay stamp duty, I am liable to pay, various other complications are there if I make trust in my lifetime. If I make for my children, then income tax is not there, but 5% stamp duty will come on immovable property. Movable property also certain stamp duty will come. So he made, and if you make a trust under the will, no stamp duty, no income tax, no gift tax, nothing is there. So he made a trust under the will. Four daughter-in-law is appointed an executor. And he made a provision that no, my immovable property will remain intact for next 18 years. Where my grandson, who is 1 year old today, he becomes 21 year old, then with the consent of four daughter-in-law and four sons, they can sell the property. So for 21 years, nobody can sell the property. One of the properties given to the rent or to Bank of Baroda. So they are earning nearly 40 lakh rupees per month. So all four daughter-in-law will get out of that 10 lakh rupees each after paying the tax, whatever tax come. So it will can be made in that way also. And many times I see the Parsi bill particularly, will is going on for 100 years. And so like that way, if you want that things, you want to think as a, remain as a simple, after my death, the asset must go like this and not legally divide the asset in 3 days and forget about the person, that is also possible. If you want to make a will like this, then nobody can sell anything, let it remember you 100 for 100 years, that is also possible. But nobody can sell, they can earn only income out of it. So it depends upon requirement of each person. Will need not be on stamp paper. Many persons feel if somebody made will on stamp paper, then also it is not invalid. It is perfect. It's like instead of ordinary paper, you use a stamp paper. But if it is on plain paper, normally will is required on a plain paper. Need not be on stamp paper, but if somebody make on stamp paper, it's fine, perfectly okay. But on stamp also, will is 100% valid. Typing is essential. So one can read easily, otherwise handwritten will be also perfect. One can write in clean handwriting. One should not use the word which have double meaning. Let us say my mother name is Sunita. My wife name is also Sunita. And let us say my daughter is also Sunita. And I just say after my death, my flat will go to Sunita. Now there is a confusion, which Sunita, mother, wife or daughter? So I must make it my Sunita, my wife, or Sunita, my daughter, or Sunita, my mother. So whenever such complications come, one must make it very, very clearly that property you want to give to whom. So recently I have seen, you know, one will, two daughter-in-law have same name. Now person said this will go to so-and-so person. And that person, his first son's wife is also that name Sunita, so let us say Sunita. Second son's wife also is Sunita. That is Sunita has to go. Then of course finally 50-50 they have divided. So one must make it clear who is the person. So handwriting is also okay. One must write in a pen in a such a way, ink is good, paper is good, things are clear, there is no overwriting, or you want to get it tight, that also perfectly okay. Now what precaution is to be taken? I simply divide my asset and I have also liabilities. I must take care of liability also. For example, I have a 4 flat and loan is taken against that property. So against 2 flat loan is taken. Now I want to give that flat to my son along with that liability of the loan. Then I must say that that particular son who is getting this flat will pay the loan amount to the bank. Otherwise what will happen? For example, I give my 4 son 4 flat. On 2 flat they loan of 2 crore. I have bank balance of say another 2 crore FDR etc. which I want to give to my wife. Then actually first loan will be paid out of my money, whatever the FDR etc. and my wife will not get anything. So I must make it clear, if certain liability is there, I want to give car, Mercedes car to one, my son number 2. And then Mercedes have loan of 30 lakh rupee. I must clarify, 30 lakh will be paid out of my fund or my son will pay, who will get the car. So liability also one has to take care. So accordingly, each person can be allotted the liability. For example, I give to 4 son. And there is an asset and there is a liability, both. Let us say son number 1 say, I don't want to take this money. Then will be not valid, invalid. It will remain valid, but son A will not get anything in case after my death, he won't own anything. Then that asset will go as per the Hindu law, or children, other children will get equally. Asset or liability, whatever. If liability is more than the asset, I may have asset of only 10 crore and liability may be 15 crore. Then the liability will be restricted only to the asset what they inherit. They are not liable to pay from their pocket. So liability cannot be more than the inheritance, more than the asset. It can be in any language, but for example, I am in Maharashtra, Hindi, English, Gujarati, Marathi. If I am in Madras, then whatever that language. So depending upon the state, you are making a will, but one must understand. For example, I am a Hindu, I am a Jain, and I make a will in Urdu. Nobody in family member understand, so that may create problem. So it must be language known. And person who make a will, he must understand that language. Let us say I am making will of my father don't understand English. Then somebody has to explain him what I have written. And the person who explain also must sign. Yes, I have explained him in Hindi or Marwadi or Gujarati or Marathi or whatever language my father understand. And the person has to witness. So the 2 witnesses who is there, they can sign, yes, he have explained. Or there can be 3rd witness also who can explain and he make his identification. What are the legal requirements for making a will? Sign on each page, for your will run into 3 pages, for example, let us say 5 pages. I make a will. So I must sign my full signature on each and every page. I simply sign on the last page, then the such will can be challenged. 2 witnesses must sign in the end. If they can also put their initial on each and every page, nothing like that. Otherwise, their full signature, name and address. On the last page, I must push my thumb impression and my photograph. And witness also will sign name, address. Then will is perfectly okay. If I want to register the will, I go to the sub-registrar's office, take appointment from them. Then I have to take my original which I made. I have to take my photograph also. I have to take my Rasan card. Earlier, my mother is in Rajasthan. When she comes to Mumbai, I just make her will in Bombay. That is not allowed now. Wherever your address is there as per Rasan card, or passport, that place only you can make a will. So, for example, my mother is in Rajasthan, she cannot register a will in Mumbai, she has to register in Rajasthan only. I am in Bombay, I cannot go to Rajasthan and register my will, I have to register in Bombay only. So, I go there, I have to obtain a doctor's certificate, I am mentally fit to make a will. a doctor certificate has to be of 2-3 days. For example, I take certificate was taken 1 month back and I vote today for registration, the registrar will not register. He say obtain a certificate of at least in last 1 week. So it is because 1 month back I will be alright. Today I may not be well. So doctor certificate, my photograph, original will, copy of either ration card or passport or PAN card, any paper where my address, name, age, 3 things are written which they can take and photograph. So ID proof like that way, where so passport, ration card, or Aadhaar card, or election card, or PAN card, such purpose. And it can be registered, fees is only 100 rupees, 20 rupees, per page they charge extra. So, and whenever, once I register, and whenever I change, that has to be registered. So I will go there again and again. Two witnesses are minimum required. A Muslim make a will, and even if no witness, it will be okay. A army man make a will in writing, no witness, it will be okay. Otherwise, will has to be witnessed by minimum 2%. Many times, 1% take one witness, will be invalid. So, it has to be minimum 2 witnesses. And person who make a will, testator and both are witness, all 3 must sign at a time. Many times, will is challenged. They say, person has signed at home, he has taken a witness of a doctor, doctor was not at home, and he was sitting in his clinic. So, let both the witness and let other one witness and party go to the doctor's office and let them sign there. Or doctor come to your place. So nowadays what I advise my client, if somebody should not challenge the will, when you sign 2 witnesses and person is sitting, take that time one photograph. So your will also come in the photo, one person is signing, 2 witnesses are sitting there. And nowadays the date also come on the photograph, I said. So better to attest that, so that is a proof that is a witness. Because I made one will actually few years back, one Maharaja was there from Gujarat. And he was 101% so because he is 4-5. So and all 4-5 had children. And few were married and few were just staying with him. So he was 100% sure that after that there is going to be big litigation over the all the estate. And he was very clear in mind also how he want to distribute the wealth. And he was clear that dispute has to be there after that. So what we have done by making the will, we have shown him, shown to the person who was with him, executor and everyone. Then we have taken full recording when he was signing. From my office, we went to registrar's office, one van was there, full church gate and everything was recorded, where we are all 3 are going there with the witness and everything. Before registrar's office also, we have taken a photograph and recording, and at the before, and we have taken a special permission for registrar, and at the time of registration also recording was there. So nobody can challenge, nobody can say afterthought, like very famous case, you know, that Bidla's case, the Mrs. Bidla of some Calcutta, she was having, so she was having wealth of nearly 10,000 crore. She made a bill in favor of her auditor, chartered accountant, Mr. Noda. Later on, Bidla family disputed that. They say we want to give for charity, our tradition is that. How an auditor can get wealth of 10,000 crores? Matter went up to Supreme Court. And Supreme Court said, no, it is a valid will. Of course, this was not in the, you know, nasib of Mr. Noda, because he himself passed away after a few years. So his children got the wealth. But end of the day, will was valid. It was signed before the 2 witnesses. It was registered properly. Mrs. Bidla was in the proper sense of mind, or documentation was proper. So then court said no, it is a perfect will, it is her own property, she can distribute whatever way she wants. And her intention was to give the charity, she would have made will like that only, why she will give to Mr. Loda. So legally, Loda succeeded in the court and finally, of course, got to children. Then, privilege and unprivileged means, privilege will means you sign in the armed forces and those persons, their oral will be allowed. Otherwise, unprivileged means writing will. Then conditional or unconditional. I can put condition in my will. If I passed away in 1 year's time, then will is valid. If I remain alive for another more than 1 year, then will is not valid. Then will be not applicable. That such condition I can put. But I cannot say that Mr. A, he do the murder of Mr. B, then only A will get this asset. This is illegal condition. So I cannot put such condition, but legal condition, yes. If that my son take care of my wife after my death, then my son will get this item. Yes, such condition is valid. It can be put that way. Then, joint will is also possible in one will. For example, my wife and me, we both make a one will. We both have a party. And we say, I say after my death, my all asset will go to my son. My wife say after her death, all asset will go to my daughter. After my death, son will, property will be reserved for the son, but son will not get it. The joint will is there, property will be divided after death of both the person. So that is known as a joint will, but normally nowadays they are not very popular. Normally we make a mirror will in the sense, I make a will, I will say everything will go to my wife. If she is not there, if she predeceases me, then it will go to my children like this. A similar way, my wife will make a will, everything will come to me. If I am not there that day, then it will go to my children like this. Now they will make that type of will, normally mirror will. Then there is a duplicate will. I can make for nowadays, so when you register, you get a CD. So as many copy you want to take, you can take and keep it, because many times what happened, after making a will, person keep will at such a place, after his death, it is not found. And after searching a lot, family member decide that there was no will, they divide as per Hindu law, and maybe 10 years down the line or 20 years down the line, they find a will. It has happened in one case. One of my clients came to my office one day at 9 o'clock. His will was going on for a couple of months. So he had not, that day he said, let us sign will today. I say, urgent kya hai, do teen din mein kar dega, mila nahi aaj ka banane ka hai. So some draft was there, I said, the typist bhi nahi hai. He said, nahi, draft hai, let us make it final. Whatever blank was there, we filled it. I signed the witness, my another staff member signed the witness, he has signed. And that day he said, okay, now the will is over, let's order a cup of tea. So I say, yaar, 10 baje kaun hotel wala aayega, but anyway, let the hotel wala open, so tea wala came. And second day morning, I seen his photograph in Times of India, he passed away at night at 2 o'clock. So God knows, he was knowing himself or what. Then what happened? After that, legal heir was not knowing that will is lying with me. So nobody approached me and will was lying with me. And I also not taken that care ke bhi after that I go to their children, and because it was just... Then another will was made after maybe 20 years for his son. And he informed his children that my will Punmiya ke padha hai. When after death of his son, grandchildren came to me. He said, daddy told me that his will is lying with you. I searched my locker, I found his son's will as well as father's will. I say, your father's will is there, dadaji ka will is there, his son's will is there. He said, dadaji ka will is there, there is no will, so we divided it by Hindu law. So one must keep 3-4 copies, one at cupboard, one at locker, one with a chartered accountant, one with advocate, and at least key person in the family, wife and son, one must inform. So whole after death, they must find the will, that is more important. And then if one do all the exercise and it is not traceable, it is like not making. But if will is registered, then one can take search of collector's office and obtain a duplicate. If it is not registered, nobody will know, government will not have no record. But if it is registered by paying 400-500 rupees, then you know, as children can go to the registrar's office, they take a search which normally costs 2,000 rupees, and they can obtain duplicate certificate from the registrar. So that is another plus point. Registration mein, when you, somebody challenges the will, it is authentic, a government of Maharashtra is witness to your will. So court also will recognize that. So legally registration is not required, but it is advisable when there is an immovable property there, when somebody feels that there may be chances of dispute because of daughter-in-law, because of son-in-law, because of something else, then it is advisable to register. Concurrent will, for example, I have property in say India, Singapore, USA, UK. The one option is there, I make a will for all the assets. Or I can make separate will for each country. India property, this is a will, US property, because each country have their own law. Somewhere there is an inheritance tax, somewhere it is not there, somewhere Islam rule is applicable, somewhere it is not applicable. So each, so for example, USA I have to pay the tax. Then that I can produce only US will. So all estate of USA, that will take care. India when there is no tax, so I can produce the Indian will. So that way also one can make a number of wills for each country separately. But as far as India is concerned, I cannot make a 10 will. Rajasthan ka property separate, Bombay property separate, Gujarat property separate, that is not possible. India mein, there has to be one will only. But for example, person is going for heart operation. And doctors tell him, you make will right now in my favor. And such, tomorrow it is proved that that person has made will under the pressure. Or for example, some case is going on in Bombay High Court or Supreme Court. And advocate tells the party, you make will in my favor right now. Or for such situation comes, daughter-in-law say, I will come to commit suicide. You make will right now in my favor. So such situation, if tomorrow it is proved that it was signed under pressure, will become completely invalid, have no force of law. So such will is called sham will. Handwritten will is not monograph will. Then who can be executor? Any person can be executor. It need not be a relative. Need not be known. It can be any well-wisher. It can be a friend. It can be any reputed person. It can be institutions. Any can be executor. Can be any person. But executor is appointing only a trustee, not the beneficiary. Executor is not the beneficiary. But for example, I want to appoint my wife as executor, And I also want to give everything to her. Yes, possible. Executor can get the money also. But then if executor is the beneficiary, then executor should not become witness to the will. For example, I appoint my wife as the executor. I am not giving anything to her. I give everything to my two children. Then my wife can be witness also. But for example, I give everything to my wife. Then my son and daughter can be witness. But for example, I appoint my wife as the executor and distribute all the assets to all the three. Then at least 3% cannot be my witness. I must avoid them and witness can be some other person. So similarly, executor can be any person. Now for example, after making a will, I realize certain assets I have not written in the will. Or I purchase some more will after assets after that. Or some assets have gone away. So what I can do? One option, I make a new will. Old is cancelled, new will will be there. Or I can make an amendment to the will, which is known as a codicil. Codicil means, for example, I purchase whatever asset I have, I made a will of that, and after that I purchase one property, another in Malabar Hill. So I can make amendment to the will. This property was not there at that point of time. I purchased afterwards, so I want to give will like gift like the inheritance like this. Or for example, I have one flat in Malabar Hill, which I give to my wife. I sold that flat and purchased two flats. Then I want to give in different way. I can make a codicil. And codicil may I not have to, I simply have to say I made will on that day. These items were not taken care because of the following reason. And I want to distribute that asset like this. I may have one flat which I already sold now. So those person who were earlier entitled for the flat, instead of flat I want to give them the money or jewelry or whatever. Then I can make amendment. Procedure of amendment is also same. If will is registered, codicil has to be registered. Will was signed before two witnesses, codicil will be before two witnesses. Will may there was an executor, same codicil also will have the same executor. So same procedure, but only you have to act on an amended part, not on the whole story. Earlier whatever was there, that will remain, this will be amended to the will. So that is known as codicil. What are the form and formality to make a will? No prescribed form, I already told you. Will, there is no stamp duty. After death also you can divide. But in case, there is a certain government properties, land needs to be transferred. Society may you not file the nomination and some there is a dispute. Then one has to obtain the probate from Bombay High Court against the will. If will is not there, then we can obtain succession certificate. Will is there, then you have to obtain the probate. Earlier rule was there, if a lady applied for the probate, there was no stamp duty. But now stamp duty is there and one has to pay 75,000 or whatever the figure for stamp duty depending upon the estate value and probate can be obtained. And now probate again, what is the probate? It is a government court tying the will on stamp paper and give them a judge sign and give you back. But there is a procedure, normally it takes 1 to 1 year. For certain number of days they put on the notice board of the High Court and some wrong person also many times create objection. And one has to obtain certificate from all the legal heirs. So, still to avoid the probate, what one must do, if properties are in a cooperative society, after making the will, we must make the nomination form also. So, for example, I make a nomination in favor of my wife. I also give a will to my wife. So, my wife will be absolute owner of the property and not have to go to obtain the probate from the High Court. So, that hassle can be avoided. Otherwise, one has to go to the High Court. And I have seen one Ashok Solanki from Rajkot always object. He always claims he is a legal heir. And one or two part gentlemen in the Kulaba, they're working only that. They go to the Bombay High Court, see all the notices wherever somebody has applied for probate, and they create unnecessary complication. And of course, they take 500,000 rupees, but they lead to a lot of unnecessary hassles created. So we must make sure. Now, for example, I want to give something to my son today itself in my lifetime. I don't want to go under the will and other thing. Then of course, I will be cease to be owner of that property. My son will not take care. He will get the property today. Then stamp duty is only 2%. Under stamp duty, I have to make a gift. But for example, I don't want to make a gift. Let us take a situation. I have a flat. I am a 70-year-old. I can't attend society affairs and everything. I make a nomination in favor of my wife. I also make will in favor of my wife. But my wife will decide that to my son. But my wife is not capable of attending the society procedure. So what I do, I make my son as an associate member. There is a simple form, form number 8, I file with the society. I simply say, I make my son as an associate member, my son will sign, I will sign, and after my name in the sale certificate, my son's name will be added. In case of my death, associate membership will come to an end as far as I am alive. So if I make my wife as an associate member, then after my death, her name will not be deleted because she is also nominee and she is also beneficiary. So even the procedure for after death, what, how property is to be transferred in the name of a nominee, that procedure also can be avoided because her name is already there in my lifetime as an associate member. For number 8, then we need not be on stamp paper. Now, if I don't want to go for registration and I simply want to have it notarized, then also it is possible. I can go to notary public, sign his register, he put the rubber stamp and everything, and it can then notary my witness. So two witness and testator, all three go to notary, it can be notarized also. But registration is better option than the notary. So avoid probate, I told you, nomination and both is important. Now friends, as far as will is concerned, practically over, let me shift to nomination and I'll give you various examples. But one thing I want to tell you, let my father made a will and he's given one property to all four children equal, all four sons equal. Then we decide after his death that we three brothers don't want the property, we want to give our fourth brother. No, property may be worth 7 crore rupees. So effectively, each person is owner of to the extent of 25 lakh each. Now if I want to give that immovable property, normally each brother is transferring property worth 25 lakh rupees. But if children are inherited and they want to release in one of the legal heir, then stamp duty is only 200 rupees. So normally we are giving property worth 75 lakh. 75 lakh at the rate of 5% is come to 3,75,000 for the registration fees. But normally stamp duty is 200 rupees. Registration fees is only 100 rupees. But only legal heir can release in favor of another legal heir. I cannot give to somebody else. There has to be a person interested in the property and it should be legal heir. Then stamp duty and registration fee is practically nil. Another important thing, let us take a situation, my father made a will. He has given me property fully. Let us assume I got one property which is worth say 1 crore rupee. My father passed away say in 2014, January. Property was transferred in my name say in June 2014. So 6 months. Now I want to sell the property. I am holding the property from June to November, say 5 months only. My father passed away in January, so say 11 months only. But when my father purchased the property, maybe 1950 when I was not even born, that will be my date of acquisition of the property. My father might have paid 300 rupees that point of time, today maybe worth 3 crore rupees. That is my cost. And I will come in the shoes of my father, his cost is my cost, his date of acquisition is my date of acquisition, and accordingly income tax, capital gain, etc. will be worked out. It is a fact, actually my father purchased one property in 1952, I was born, for 300 rupees in my name. And of course money was paid by him, so it was appearing in his balance sheet. After his death, I got the property. And 1/3 of that portion I sold for 1 crore rupees. So his date of acquisition of 1952 is my date of acquisition. His cost of 300 rupees become my cost, but because it was before 1981, so I can substitute the market value of 1981. For example, the property was purchased for 300. In 1981, it was worth 5 lakh rupees. Then I can substitute the figure of 5 lakh as my cost, and accordingly I can apply indexation and pay the taxes or invest in bond or buy another property or whatever. So that way, what I want to say, whenever property is received under the will or inheritance, then cost of that person is the cost of the new person. Date of acquisition of that person is the date of acquisition of the new person. Now, as far as nomination is concerned, I told you, nomination means appointing a trustee. That person will act as a trustee, and when nomination can be made at a time of investment. Like for example, we take the policy of LIC, GIC, bank FDR. That time, normally bank say, who is your nominee? A nominee will get the property. Nominee will get, as far as society is concerned, for example, I make my son as a nominee, his name is transferred. Society will transfer in his name, but he is only a trustee. When he sells the property, he has to divide to all. Before that, nominee property is transferred and somebody object from the family. He is simply a nominee. Society should not allow him to sell the property without our consent. Then society will not allow them to sell the till all legal heir come in the picture. If will is there, then of course society will say as per will it will go. Or then in case of dispute, probate can be obtained. But nominee is simply a trustee and not the owner of the property. I will give you two, three judgment of the Bombay High Court on that point. Same way, nomination also can be changed, like will every day you can change. First nomination, when filing the society, it is free, no expenses, no charges. When you want to make a second nomination, 5 rupee fees is there, we normally no society, normally charge. But and when you make the nomination form in the case of a property, I simply have to write my name, address, my sales certificate number, my flat number, floor, and who is the beneficiary. If there is a single nominee, I want to give to my wife 100%, then form number 15A is there. I want to give more than one, partly to my wife, partly to my son, partly to my daughter, then I can write their name and their percentage, and this is the way I want to give. Now let us take a situation, I have purchased a flat where my name is first, I paid for it, but my wife's name is appearing as second. Now whether I can make a nomination or no. If society not adopted new model bylaws of 2001, it is following old bylaws, then first person is the owner for all purposes. All second, third is the only associate member, and I am within my power to make a nomination either in favor of my wife, then her name will remain. I can make nomination in favor of my son. After my death, my wife's name will remove because he is only an associate member, and I am the main member. And if I make a nomination in favor of my son, society will transfer property in name of my son. But after 2001, if society adopted new model bylaws, and my name and wife's name is also there, and both have paid for it, then see, let us assume both are 50-50. She paid 50%, I paid 50%. Then I am 50% owner of the property, she is 50% owner of the property. I can make my nomination regarding my 50%, she can make her nomination regarding her 50%. But bylaws are earlier to 2001, we both have paid the money, still society will recognize me as the owner and not my wife. So which bylaws are there, that also has to be taken into account. And nomination is concerned, HUF, firm, company cannot make nomination. All institutions cannot make nomination. Nominee can be a same principle, adult, minor or unsound mind person cannot make, minor cannot make, those conditions are there. But you can make nomination in favor of a minor. But till he attains the age of 18 years, somebody will represent as a guardian, and accordingly things will go ahead. Now what are the right of nomination? Nominee can do everything what original owner can do. For example, nominee sell the property, then he has to distribute the legal heir, all the legal heir, and accordingly it will be divided. Nominee cannot make further nomination. For example, I give flat to my wife as a nominee. I have not made a will in her favor. Then she cannot file nomination. See, all my legal heir will be owner of the property. But for example, I have also given her under the will. Then she is the owner. Then she can file further nomination. So nominee cannot make the further nomination. Now, if nomination is not filed, if nomination is filed, society will act after the nomination. For example, I made a nomination in my wife's favor. After my death, my wife will write to the society, include my death certificate, attach the copy of nomination form. If she is not member already, application for the membership. Society may insist one for indemnity bond maximum. Okay, you are the 100%, nomination is already there. So it is binding on the society to transfer in her name. But sometimes they say, okay, I am holding on behalf of the following legal heirs. And accordingly, society will transfer. Now let us take a situation. I have not made a will, I have not filed nomination also. Then what happened? I have a flat, will is not there, nomination is not there. But society people knows, yes, Punmiya have only one wife, only one son, only one daughter. Then they will say, all three jointly make an application to the society, attach the death certificate, make an indemnity bond to 200 stamp paper, we are the only legal heir. If tomorrow any person claim we are responsible, advertisement can be given in 2 papers, one English and one Marathi. One Marathi of course necessary, any other one language, and 5 papers with the society, and society committee member and all members know, yes, we know them, they are staying here for last 30 years, and they will apply their mind, and on basis of public notice, they will also put on the notice board of the society, any member have any objection can write to them, and within 30 days, society can pass. But if I made a nomination, all procedure can be avoided, nothing has to be done. Made a will also, then person become legally owner, and both the purpose will be served on that. If nominee is not able to find sale certificate, then normally many times it happens. Because where endorsement, for example, after my death, certificate has to be
transferring name of my wife as per the nomination. So my wife has to go to the society with the certificate, then only they will endorse it. Now, majority of time, such certificate is not traceable. Because it is a flat heuristic. Normally you keep some paper somewhere and God knows it disappeared. Then one can apply for the duplicate certificate. Duplicate certificate, again advertisement to public notice, indemnity bond, society will put again public notice, 30 day notice on the notice board, and duplicate will be given. Now once duplicate is given and original is found, original is no value. I'll give you an example. Actually, once I went to Surat to give some lecture, and as per our term system of the Institute of Chartered Accountant, they send you all advance ticket, well in advance, a second AC for going, second AC for coming, and everything nicely. So you know which seat number and where you to go. So I went to Surat, given my lecture, ending my was coming back. And by that time, I was not able to trace my ticket. I was seeing my own pocket and ticket was not available. So I requested the organizer, my ticket to gum gaya hai, ya to Bombay se liya nahi hai, upar niche ho gaya. Then immediately the organizer went to the station and obtained the duplicate certificate, ticket. Because they had all the details. So he is going to say that this is the duplicate ticket. So then meantime, I found my original also. But that was some, you know, in between some pocket it was fixed. So I said, I original to mil gaya, so I destroyed the duplicate. I was sitting in the train, second AC mein, DT came ticket. So I saw him, I had the original ticket sitting. Bola, ye to cancel ho gaya, where is the duplicate of this? I said, duplicate mein phaad ke phek diya. They say, you are without ticket now, and I have to pay penalty. So once duplicate certificate issued, original even you found have no value. So duplicate will be treated as a original. So before you apply for the duplicate, make sure original is really not traceable. Because the whole life, you know, it will be written on duplicate on that. And for example, duplicate is also misplaced. Third time you go, then they will say duplicate of duplicate. So whenever you want to sell the property, you want to mortgage the property, bank will go into detail, why duplicate the duplicate, where is the original, and number of questions will come. So make sure such papers are kept safe. And don't put, you know, nowadays everyone go for that term, plastic coating. What is it?
Lamination.
Now once you put lamination on that, its certificate becomes invalid. It is a duplicate certificate now. So again you have to obtain duplicate certificate really, genuine, original. So again make sure you put it in such a plastic folder, it is not laminated, it is an original, remain as original. Once it is laminated, it has no value. Normally we say let us protect the important paper, but instead of protecting it, paper has no value. Now what is the difference between will and nomination? Nomination is simply appointing a trustee. Will, you are giving the property to somebody. That is the main difference. Practically, procedure is same in both the situations. Whether will also to be executed when nomination is given, yes, we already discussed. One case I will tell you, very famous, interesting case. One person was there, Vishnu Ghanekar. What he has done, he made a family settlement deed. Under family settlement deed, this particular property was given to the son. And other son got different value, wife got some property or whatever distribution was made. But nomination was filed for the particular property in name of a wife. So after death of the gentleman, wife went to the society, the plot society, the number of plots and bungalows were there. And property was transferred in the name of wife on the basis of nomination. Family settlement, society was not aware. The lady made agreement with one builder to sell the property and take an earnest money of say 15 lakh rupees. Total deal was for 1.5 crore. Now, meantime, son had come to know about this transaction. So son had filed case against the mother that under family settlement, I am entitled for the property. Mother is nominee, she is holding as a trustee on my behalf. And also file case against the builder that how you can purchase the property from somebody else when I am the owner. Similarly, builder has filed case against the lady. That you, specific performance, that you already taken 15 lakhs to complete the transaction. Matter went to Bombay High Court. And Bombay High Court very clearly say, the lady was the nominee, simply a trustee. Property was given to the son. Son is the real owner of the property. And lady have no right to sell the property. And son has not committed anything with the builder. So builder have no right. He bought, you know, something for the I sale Chandigarh railway station to you. And he paid money also. And tomorrow you go and take a delivery of, for example, I take a ticket of 5 rupees, take you to the Chandigarh station, so you on the platform for 2 hours. Okay, apna ye bhi train bhi apna hai, platform bhi apna hai, ye bhi apna, sab apna hai apna hai. And after 2 hours, you know, you say I paid money to the Punmiya. You say, Kaun Punmiya? Punmiya is not owner, how we can sell? So High Court said the builder has no right to purchase from nominee. Son is the real owner. Mother had no right because she was simply a nominee, and court has passed very clear order in that what are the right of nominee, what is right under the will. Now friends, few days back, you know, midday paper has published an article for 2 days continuously. They have written, they have made a note for their readers, any person have question, ask any question on nomination and will, they can write to midday paper. So they got nearly 600 questions. They have analyzed that, majority by duplicate. So finally they have analyzed 20 questions on will and nomination, which they forwarded to me. I have given reply, and one day they have published everything on the will, and second day published on the nomination. So I will just give reply of their question and answer. So their 99% of question will be solved. If anything there, we will solve. Now, what is the will and benefit of making a will? Will means how to administer the estate. When you are not there, that is the whole purpose of the will. How you want to divide the asset. So, administration of estate, distribution of assets to a person, like what I want, wish of the person, appoint a person whose administration to do the administration, appoint a guardian if there is a minor, and all these things. And this will be effective only after death of the person. Till person is alive, it is not effective. Then second question, should everybody, working or non-working person, male or female, make a will, or what if you die without making a will? It is advisable, because once we are born, death is, rest everything is certain, but death 100% is certain. And when person will die, nobody knows. So always better to make a will. Because remind me, 1997, I went to USA to give some lecture there. So DM Harris was my guru. So first time I was going abroad in 1997, I went to Mr. DM Harris to take his blessings. He said, I am going on the cost of a client to give lecture. I am not spending a single penny from my pocket. So that was another honor. You go to USA for 1 month and don't spend a single penny. So Mr. Harris said, have you made your will? So I go, said, sir, I am going for one type of holidays and you are talking about will. I said, sir, I have not made any will. In 97, I was just, 35 or maybe 45 year old. So I said, sir, I am not, he said, right now, go to your office. I said, say 9 o'clock in night, abhi kya will karega? Well, go, take mind paper, but mind paper. At least write your name, address, age, and say whatever immovable, movable property I have, I give to my wife. And take a signature of your son and daughter. Mr. Harris was my guru, so I went to my office, written a small will, taken witness of my son and daughter, and given to my wife. Believe me, nothing has happened. But when I was sitting in a plane, I was comfortable. Yes, we will kar liya hai. Anything opens, I will save it. So, psychologically also, you have a lot of thing. So, one must make a will, if tomorrow you can destroy. When should people make a will, at what age? Anyway, age is okay, but at least after 50, one must make a will. Question 4, how do you make this will? If there is a process of making a will, what kind of paper is to be used? What language is to be written? Do they need people's witness? Already discussed in detail, ordinary paper, no stamp paper, simple writing. Type is better, avoid complicated word where a double meaning is there, and to witness and person must sign each and every page. Where should they keep the will when they finish writing it? Should somebody in the family, friend know where they have kept? Yes, better somebody knows, or otherwise let us keep with a friend or advocate or chartered accountant or locker. It is found after death, that is more important. 6, can a will be verbal like told to a person before death, or does it have to be in writing? It has to be in writing. Only Muslim family verbally go. Question 7. We see lot of problem in family when head of the family passes away without leaving a will. Is this true? Would things be easier? Yes, it is better. I will just give an example. Raj Mata, Gwale Raj family only. Jiwarjora Sindhya passed away somewhere in 1949, immediately after the partition. And that time mother of Sindhya and all four daughters, including Chief Minister of Rajasthan, they were all were minor. In 1949, they were the HUF, Jiwarjora Sindhya HUF. So Rajmata Vijay Raja Sindhya was the karta of the HUF, because Mother of Sindhya was a minor that time, so minor cannot be karta, mother was karta. After Mother of Sindhya become major, still mother was going on, but there was no confusion. Then some after a few years, maybe 30-40 years after that, some dispute started in family. So mother has made a will in favor of four daughters and not given anything to the son. Then finally matter went to the High Court. That Maharani was the Rajmata was the only karta of the HUF. She was, it was not her property. She cannot make will on that property. Automatically, once Maharaja attained the age of 18 years, Maharaja became karta of the HUF. But he not objected, the mother was going on. So finally, will was treated as an invalid will. In case of Birla, it was treated as a valid will because there was individual property. In case of Malani, it was treated as an invalid will because as a HUF karta, you can't make a will. Second court said, again, she is not the co-partner. In case of a HUF, for example, let us take my HUF, Vimal Punmiya HUF, I am the manager. My son is the co-partner. My daughter is the co-partner. Co-partner means they can claim partition. My wife is not co-partner, she is a member. She can claim maintenance. If I am not maintaining her, she can claim maintenance from HUF. My wife is the co-partner of her father's HUF. So lady, even she is everything, she is your wife, she control everything, but she still cannot claim partition of your HUF. Her right is much lower than son's right. So Maharani was again a lady, so she is not co-partner, he has no right. First of all, she cannot make a will, and second, she has no right in HUF property. Simply, she can claim maintenance if somebody is not maintaining her. Her own wealth was in couple of 100 crores, so maintenance is not even required. So whole will was treated as an invalid will. So that is the point, that you can't make will of somebody else's property. Here it was HUF property, you are simply a karta. Should one keep the content of will secret or can they be shared with people? Depend upon person to person, there is no hard and fast rule. A husband may leave a will, should a wife also make a will, or can husband and wife can make a joint will? Yes, joint will is possible. Husband can make will, wife can make a will, whatever way they want, it is okay. I received one will recently. One of my client, husband and wife, husband is 95, still alive, wife passed away at 85. And wife, this was the fourth marriage, earlier three marriages, first was a Parsi, second was Muslim, third was Sardarji, and fourth was Parsi. Wife also got married four times, husband also got married four times. First was some in USA, some Jew or something, second time in Pakistan, third time in England, different community, different caste, and fourth time with this lady. Husband had three children, with each marriage one person was there, two sons and one daughter, wife also had two daughters and one son. So the six children were there total. In the fourth marriage, there were no children. And all were lucky, incidentally, all six children chartered accountant. All are from England. And one is a Sindhi, one is a Sardarji, one is a Christian, one is a Muslim, all national integration full. Now wife made a will. And children calls, wife's children call only at the time of her birthday, between 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock. Their date is given. If they don't call before 8 o'clock, then forget it. 1 year is over, after 1 year call. Otherwise they don't call and either she will take the phone. Similarly, husband's children will call only on his birthday between 6 to 8, one day in a year. So that was the system. Now wife made a will. She had nearly 10 crore rupees, 10 to 12 crore rupees. A property where they stay is a tenant property. After their death, it will go back to the landlord. It returned the will. If you don't want this property, we stay there for 50 years. After our death, let the property go back to the landlord. Very clearly it is returned. And husband had nearly 10-15 crore, wife had 10-15 crore. Now wife given 25% to the carpenter, who is permanent carpenter in their family, you know, whole day he is doing something. So 25% to the servant, 25% to the driver, 25% to the one hospital, animal hospital in lower. So nothing is given to the husband. Husband having his own property, husband also will, when will open, will be like that only. So basically, it is my property, I can distribute whatever way I want. There is no restriction, I have to give to my children only, I have to give to my wife only, I have to give to my, I can do whatever I want. And this is a running example, very clearly given to servant, driver, servant, carpenter, and hospital. Suppose a person make a will leaving his asset and money not to a family but to outsider or perhaps to a charity, is 100% okay, I am giving my own property, but I must give in my proper senses. It should not happen in the morning I had a fight with my wife, after I had a fight with my son, and evening I make a will, that I am not in my proper senses. I must understand with cool mind and make a will perfectly okay. Will are often contested by a people. Can you enumerate three or four more common ground in which will normally is contested? Like person was of not sound mind, testator lacks testamentary capacity to sign a will. Now always the person don't know English and signature in English. So such way one can challenge that. A person was unduly influenced into the signing a will. Will is made under the pressure. Will are procured by fraud. A will is not signed before the two witnesses. Name of the family member is not mentioned. For example, I write name of my wife and son, daughter name is not written. I feel my daughter is married, well, settled, I've given everything in my lifetime. So I know, but my daughter can challenge that. So I must write her name in the will and just say, I don't want to give to my daughter because I've already given in my lifetime. So then she cannot claim because application of mind is there for that. I'm not giving anything to my wife because she already has the wealth. Or she is staying separately. I must clarify directly why I am not giving them. Will often result into bitterness in the family and fragmentation. Maybe somebody thinks they have got, ये कहावत है, दूसरे की बीवी आपको हमेशा अच्छी दिखती है. सो ऑलवेज यू नो इवन फादर इज गिवन इक्वल टू टू चिल्ड्रन. फर्स्ट सन विल फील आपने सेकंड को ज्यादा दिया, सेकंड का बेटा सोचेगा फर्स्ट को ज्यादा दिया. दैट ऑलवेज फीलिंग इज देयर. सो यू मस्ट मेक इट क्लियर दिस इज अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूट. दिस इज बिकॉज यू शुड से ऑल फोर एसेट विल गो टू 4% इक्वली. यू मे हैव वन फ्लैट, यू मे हैव अ जेवरी बाजार. हाउ दे कैन डिवाइड द फ्लैट, हाउ दे डिवाइड द जेवरी बाजार शॉप. सो मेक इट क्लियर flat will go to so and so person, shop will go to so and so person, or they will sell the shop and divide equal portion. So there is no confusion, things should be very clear. Have there been cases in which a will has been deliberately tampered with, or when there may be mentally unsound people have made fooled into making a will? Very few are there, yes, but not normally. Can a person change a will he has already made? Before signature of the will, I can make a corrections in will and put initial and also take initial of the witnesses. After signature is over, after witness is signed, I make the correction and even initiate, will be invalid. So don't make any correction, either make an amendment, codicil, or make a new will itself. After signature, don't make a will. If will is already registered, they have the copy, and then I go on making the changes, my whole purpose will be defeated. What would you advise? Always make a will with a cool head, never in a rash or unclusive manner. What should be a person's state of mind when they make? Yes. Cool mind, nicely understand that when you are in normal sense, that time you know, you understand what you are doing and that time it is to be done. Should there be a help of a lawyer? Yes, things are very complicated, better to contact a lawyer who can make a will. If things are very simple, then one can make the will, there is no problem. Does marriage entering into civil partnership affect? Yes, today for I am not married. I make a will. I give everything to my mother and father or my brother. After my marriage, that will come to an end. Because the whole concept has changed. I want to give to my wife now. Even I not change the will be invalid. Now let us take a situation. I give an inheritance to my wife and I must take place tomorrow. Then will come to an end. I have to make a new will. So old will, even it is there, I not change the will, still it is invalid. It will, because these are the main criteria of making a will, marriage and divorce. Does divorce dissolve the civil partnership, affect the will? Yes. Property will be inherited to nominee under nomination. That I already given an example about that Bombay High Court decision. Justice Deshpande has given decision on 9th April 2009. He said, nominee is simply a trustee, not the owner. Under will, you get the property. A member is not in capacity to attend society meeting, then 4 number 8, I told you, that even associate member can become chairman and secretary of the building. But in the death of the main member, associate membership will come to an end. A nomination is also there in favor of associate member, he will continue as a nominee. If will is also there, then of course he is a beneficiary. So all three things can be also done at the same time. I want to give flat to my son, I make him associate member, I make nomination in his favor, and also make a will in his favor. Now all three things will be over. Then friend, of course, format of will which you already discussed. Another 3-4 thing I want to tell you, very important, may not be connected will, but it is have lot of bearing on will. Because many person they come to my office to make a will. They say, we have purchased the flat 10 years back, lot of black money was paid. Even official money, when I paid by check, I deposited cash in my bank account. I have not paid stamp duty. I have not registered. But today I make a will in favor of my son or wife or daughter. After that, department will come to know about this and there will be lot of problem for my children. So how to solve it? Question 1, in a cooperative society, registration is optional. When you purchase the property, agreement is not registered, no problem, it is the same value. Section 41 of Maharashtra Cooperative Society Act says registration is optional. If I want to take a loan from bank, that bank insists for registration, but otherwise unregistered document has the same value which registered document has. Second, stamp duty not paid up to 9th December 1985, your purchases before that stamp duty was not applicable at that point of time. But assuming agreement is after that, Government of Maharashtra comes every after 3-4 years, there is amnesty scheme. You pay the stamp duty under that, token penalty of 300 or 500 or 1000 rupees fees will be there, and things can be regularized. Even you want to pay otherwise stamp duty, for example, I purchased flat in 1979. I not paid stamp duty that point of time. I want to pay today. What is the penalty? Now, if I agreement is dated 1979, I paid money in 1979, I am holding sales certificate of society from 1979, I am occupying the property from 1979, income tax, passport or record will say 1979. Then I go to the stamp duty department with that document, then whatever the market value of 1979 will be applicable. Up to 4 July 1980, I was able to pay stamp duty on a cost value, not on a market value. If I purchase after 1980, after 4 July 1980, it may be market value of that date of 80 or 81 or whatever. So let us take the situation 1979, I purchased the flat and I am liable to pay stamp duty that time, say 50,000 rupees. I got paid, so today if I pay under the scheme, no penalty. If the scheme is not there, I want to pay today, then I have to liable to pay 2% interest per month. Now 1979 to 2014, it will be nearly 35 years. 35 years is 420 months. At the rate of 2%, it comes to 840%. So stamp duty may be 50,000, penalty will work out to 420,000. But stamp duty, there is a provision, your interest cannot be double of the stamp duty payment. So even I am liable to pay 840%, my amount will freeze at 1 lakh. Stamp duty 50,000, interest can be 1 lakh. And I can pay 1,50,000, matter will close once for all. If stamp duty payable is only 10,000, it will be 20,000. So accordingly, things can be worked out. So stamp duty is not that serious. And whenever government brings the scheme, you pay under that and chapter will be over. As far as cash money deposited in bank account at the time of making payment to the builder, income tax department cannot travel beyond 6 years. So whatever money you have deposited 6 years back, up to 31st March 2007, whatever happened, income tax cannot touch you. So for, let us say I purchased flat in 2005 and I deposited say 50 lakhs in a bank account. Department cannot do anything. I will give an example. One of my client, Mr. Morarka, he was raided by income tax department. From his lockup, jewelry of 50 lakh, hard cash of 50 lakh was found. Question was asked Mr. Morarka, sir, what is source of this? He said, it's a low number guy. I have not officially purchased this. The department said, then pay tax on this. He said, that I will not pay. He said, why? He said, you cannot travel beyond 6 years. And I purchased this jewelry 8 years back. I deposited this cash in my locker 8 years back. He said, you prove it. He was sure because his wife passed away 8 years back and after that he did not touch the locker. He went to the Bank of India, obtained a certificate from bank and Mr. Morarka not operating locker in last 7 years. And accordingly, income tax could not do anything. So those persons who purchased the property before 31st March 2007, don't have to worry. Make the will and without fear, you can do whatever you want to write. I can see many ladies. Under Income Tax Act, a lady can, many times what happened, person when buy the flat. Let's say I want to buy a flat in Borivali. I have to pay 50 lakh rupees check to the builder. I don't have money. So what I do? I go and Jewelry Bazaar, sell some gold ornament, take the check and give to the builder. Now there is an income tax man, which is a circular of 1995. A married woman can have gold ornament to the extent of 500 gram. Unmarried can have to the extent of 250 gram. And male can have to the extent of 100 gram. Income tax department cannot ask you any question from what is the source and from where you got it. And why the circular came? Before 1995, when the income tax department used to conduct a search or survey, they used to remove the Mangalsutra bangles of the lady and seize it. And that was the removing a Mangalsutra of a lady in Maharashtra is insult to her, big insult actually. In Bihar, Rajasthan or Uttar Pradesh, you remove the bangle of a lady. So that way, government came with the circular. A married woman can have gold ornament to the extent of 500 gram, no question. Unmarried 250 gram. Male can have 100 gram, no question can be asked. Even during the course of raid, stock in trade, maybe if I am a jeweler, my stock will be gold ornament only. Fixed deposit receipt, I have bank FDR of 25 lakh. Even in the outside books of accounts, department cannot touch that. They can make an inventory. They can ask you a number of questions, but they cannot take away, they cannot seize it, they cannot stop payment from the bank. Because if they stop the payment, they can seize the stock, or they take the FDR, then you are going to lose the income. Now you will be losing the income, income will also lose the tax on that. So earlier, you know, they used to apply their mine, without application of mine, they used to seize it. Party was making losses and he was not paying taxes. So SSC was suffering, department was equally suffering. So they say, even in the case of raid, unaccounted stock, FDR cannot be seized, cannot be attached, cannot be taken away.
Sorry? Is it only
FDR that can be seized? Yeah, FDR. Fixed deposit receipt of the company, fixed deposit of the bank.
What about NCD?
NCD?
NCD.
That also will go on the same line. That also will go on the same line. Now, Then we start the question answer after just 2 minutes, just 3 minutes. Whole Mumbai, you have nearly 20,000 buildings, old building. Our South Mumbai, you have nearly 3,000, which is going under redevelopment. And luckily, under redevelopment, 4 if I have 1,000 square foot area. My building go under redevelopment, I get 1,300. So question comes whether the 300 extra what I am getting is taxable or not. Now number of decisions have come from the tribunal, that whatever extra area you are getting is not taxable. Society normally today maintenance may be 1,000 rupees. After new building is over, it may be 60 floor tower, maintenance may come to 10,000, which project member cannot afford. So builder gives so much money to the society as a corpus, if society can invest in the bank, and by income, interest income, society can run. So question came whether that amount is taxable. Tribunal decided whatever corpus money comes to the society is not taxable because there is no cost to it. Temporary building will be under construction for 3 years. Builder give me some rent, you shift to some other place for 3 years. If the rent what I am getting, I am spending, then I will get a reduction. If I don't spend, I have to pay tax on that. My inconvenience will be cost to me. Today I may be traveling 10 km, under redevelopment I will shift at some another 20 km. My office will be away, my children's education, everything will suffer. So I get hardship allowance from builder. And sometimes hardship allowance itself run into 50 lakh or 1 crore. That amount also is not taxable because any item which has no cost and you get something is not taxable. I will give an example. One of my clients, he was partner with two other persons. Let us say A, B and C, three persons were there. They made one private limited company. All three have contributed 1 crore rupees and they purchased one plot in Virar. They contributed another 3 crore and doubled the property. So cost of each person was 2 crore, 2 crore, 2 crore. All three were directors, all three were equal shareholders. Now today the market value of the Virar property is nearly 600 crore. Mr. A wanted to sell his share for 200 crore. He found a buyer from Dubai. He agreed to sell the property to that person for 200 crore. Dubai party paid him the money. He is given his shares and also written a letter to the company, you transfer my share in name of Mr. So-and-so and my directorship in name of Mr. So-and-so. Now this was a private limited company. My client who had serial number 2, he said this is a private limited company, you can't sell shares to outsider. First you have to offer to the present shareholder. And present shareholder said no, then only you can sell to outsider. So my client said, I am buyer at 200 crore, you can't sell to Dubai party. By that time Dubai party already paid the money. So Dubai party came to Mumbai. He approached Mr. C. C said, I am not interested whether you buy or me buy. Neither I am interested in selling nor I am interested in buying. So C was clear. A wanted to sell. So the Dubai party finally approached my client who was at B. He said, I want to buy. This is my 200 crore lying in the bank and I want to buy. So I will become 2/3. You will, my third person will remain 1/3. So Dubai party finally settled with my client and paid him 20 crore rupees just to give his NOC. So my client got 20 crore. He said, you go ahead with the transaction. So the question came whether this 20 crore is taxable or not. What is the cost for him? Earlier he was 1/3, today also he was 1/3. Earlier he was director, today he is director. So no cost. So there is a Supreme Court decision in income tax, DC Srinivasan Shetty's case, 128 ITR. They say when there is no cost and you get the money, it is a tax free, not liable to tax. So same principle, corpus money received by the society, hardship allowance received by the flat owner, extra area received by the builder, flat owner is not taxable at all. So recently all judgment comes, I thought is very important. When you make a will and building is under redevelopment, then you must know where you stand. Now friends, last one example I will just tell you, then we'll come to the question answer. Legally, whatever planning you make, because there is even judgment of Supreme Court in case of McDonald's case, any planning you do which result into reduction of the taxes is not colorful planning and not allowed. Then after that Supreme Court gave a number of judgment, a person will make the planning not to increase the tax, to reduce the tax only. So then Supreme Court said, any planning which you do, which reduction in the taxes is perfectly okay, provided they are in four corners of law. Avoidance of tax is permitted, evasion is not permitted. I cannot avoid the tax, in four corners of law it is perfectly okay. For that purpose I will give one example. Then start question answer. One lady came to my office few months back, or maybe rather 2-3 years back. She was 80 year old. She came with her son-in-law and she said, Mr. Punmiya, I have purchased one flat in 1978 for 1 lakh rupees. Today market value of the flat is 3 crore rupees and I want to give that flat to my son-in-law as a gift. I have opened the stamp duty act. I say, madam, if you give this flat as a gift to your daughter, stamp duty is 2%. If give to your son-in-law, it is a 5%. Under income tax act, my daughter is my relative, my son-in-law is my relative, my son is my relative, my daughter-in-law is my relative. My grandchildren is my relative, my parents are my relative. My wife is my relative. But under stamp duty act, my daughter is my relative, but my son-in-law is not my relative. My son is my relative, but my daughter-in-law is not my relative. So if I give to my relative, and my wife is my relative. My two generations down is my relative, two generations up is my relative. So if I give to my relative, stamp duty is 2%, otherwise 5%. So son-in-law is not relative. Under income tax is relative, so no problem. Under stamp duty, you have to pay, I say madam, you have to pay 5%. So 3 crore, it will be 15 lakh rupees. If you make a will in favor of your son-in-law, you pay no stamp duty. And you can make also nomination. So son-in-law reacted, that mummy, why you are giving gift to me? You give to your daughter. So we pay only 2% at all you want to. First you make, don't give a gift, make a nomination or will. But at all you are very keen in giving a gift, give to your daughter. So you pay only 2% and not 5%. Mother-in-law was very clear. She said, hey, I want to give to you only. If to give to my daughter, she will take divorce from you and settle somewhere else. If I give to you, I am sure you will take care of my daughter. So she was very clear. And the daughter is also chartered accountant. Son-in-law is also chartered accountant. Both are working in the bank. Now second, daughter, mother and son-in-law, all three came. Daughter is also not worried to be given to son-in-law, but her worry is, why you given to, why we pay 15 lakh when we can settle in 6 lakh? And why first to give a gift at all? But mother was very clear and she was very clear to give to son-in-law only. Daughter said, Mr. Punmiya, give me 1 week time. So she met a half a dozen person, Supreme of Stamps, Collector of Stamps, Inspector General of Stamps, and other various advocates. And after 4 days, she called me, we want to see you. I have certain scheme, and which our tax will be only 2%. I also thought, come. I said, bring your mother also so we can decide. She came. She said, scheme is like this. First, my husband take divorce from me. My husband get married to my mother. So they become husband and wife. She complete the gift transaction, pay only 2%. After transaction is over, again take divorce from my mother, and again get married to me. I said, madam, two divorce, two marriage, how is this possible? He said, our advocate is there. He said, we charge 50,000 rupees and he will do everything in 6 months' time with consent. And finally, see, then I asked the old lady, mummy, aapko jamega 80, sab son-in-law ke saath shaadi karna. Bola, ghar mein teen log hai, meri beti, mera jamai aur main. Paper mein kiska husband kaun aur kiski wife kaun, what difference will make if he can save 9 lakh rupees. So, end of the day, what I want to convey, any planning in four corner of law, whether it is associate membership or nomination or will or gift, or release deed is perfectly okay, it fits in four corner of law. Then thank you very much. Now question answer is there.